Hello everyone, welcome to Transition Tuesdays. For this Tuesday, September 17th, 2019, I am your host, Russ Williams. I'm glad you could be here today. I'm quite aware you could have been anywhere in this world today. I know you could have been anywhere in this world today, but you decided to be here with me, and I appreciate that. And more importantly, I appreciate you. So welcome to Transition Tuesdays, everybody. Well, guys, before I start the show, I like to go over my intentions for the show, for Transition Tuesdays. And my intentions, they don't usually change, and they're quite simple. My intentions are to give you the opportunity to laugh, smile, think, and engage in honest conversations about life's transitions. So if you need to find out what the, what the intentions are, those are the intentions of Transition Tuesdays, as I am your humble host. Now, as you guys know, I can't fly this plane alone. That's why I have my lovely co-host, who just happens to be my mom. Ladies and gentlemen, the lovely and talented Miss May. Miss May.
Hello, everyone.
What's going on, Ma? How are you?
Very well.
Good, good. Very nice. Well,
welcome to Transition Family.
Tuesday. Yeah, that's right. Family, Transition Tuesdays, absolutely. Yeah, we go by many names, right, Mom? Absolutely. So, no, welcome everybody to Transition Tuesdays. We have John joining us. Hey, John, I had a question for you, man. I love watching your pieces on Facebook. What's the name of your company, man? Shout it out. I want to give a shout out to your company. We have Katrina joining us. Hi, hello, Katrina. Pleasure to meet you. Welcome to Transition Tuesday. I think this is the first for Katrina. Welcome to Transition Tuesday. You come to the right place.
Welcome, guys.
So, hey, before we start, Ma, I just want to talk about last week's show. We had, and shout out to last week's special guest. We had Gary Vitti on the show last week. Yeah. Great storyteller, Gary Vitti.
Great storyteller.
His book is titled 32 Years of Titles and Tears from the Best Seat in the House. So, you know, he's a great storyteller. GV, he gave us some GV gems, yes. You know, which was really cool, you know. So go out there and get that book. It's a great read. It's definitely a great read. Yes. So shout out to you, Gary, man. Hope everything's going well with
you. Wait till I get it.
That's right. You got to get the book, right, Mom?
I got to get the book.
Yeah, okay, Gary. You got to send us two books, man. You got to send us a book, buddy. Okay, we'll talk about that later. We have Ron DeClario joining us, Cardoza's Finest Hall of Famer, my high school Hall of Famer joining us, Ron DeClario, which we had on the show before. Yep, we had Ron on the show before. So, yeah, man, welcome. Welcome, everybody, to Transition Tuesday. So, there's been a theme of athletics going around, Ma, which we're going to talk about today. We got Steven joining us. We got Elizabeth joining us. Welcome. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Transition Tuesdays. Welcome. Glad you could make it. So I want to talk a little bit more briefly about the transition to college athletes getting paid. This is really becoming a reality sooner than later.
Yeah.
You know, and we touched upon it a couple of weeks ago. Yeah, we touched upon it a couple of weeks ago about this transition. I want to go over some recent late breaking news and developments about the college athletes maybe getting paid. And who else we got, Mom? We got Tom joining us. John says, okay. Hey, John, yep, good to see you both. Thanks for the plug. That's right. Yeah, I'm gonna post that. Hopefully everybody can see that. I'm gonna post John's business. You know, he has some great custom benches. I know he does that. He makes some great pieces. So I'm gonna post that for you, John. Yeah, man. Some great stuff on there. We're definitely going to post that out to you. No doubt about that. We're going to do that for you. Yeah. So here's the deal, guys, in terms of like student athletes possibly getting paid. Now, there's a bill. A bill was passed in California State Assembly that will allow college athletes to get endorsement deals. Okay. Now, if this bill goes through, it will allow college athletes in the state of California. So we're talking about the state of California only. Okay, only in the state of California, okay? To be paid for their name, their image, and their likeness. And pursue similar endorsement opportunities provided by Olympic athletes. Like, for example, Ma, let's say, I forget the young lady who was good on, she did the, she's an Olympic champion. I think Dominique Dawes, I think her name is. I think that's her name. Well, she had an opportunity, like her and other athletes, to be on the Wheaties box, right?
Oh, yeah.
So
yeah,
she got paid endorsements like that, even though she was a collegiate athlete, mm-hmm. Okay? So this particular deal will allow the student athletes only in California to get endorsement deals. So this bill is called the Fair Pay to Play Act. Okay, that's the name of it. And if this bill is signed into law, the Fair Pay for Play Act wouldn't go into effect until 2023. So it'll come in 4 years from now.
4 years from now.
But the most important thing about it is it would have immediate implications for recruiting athletes. Because what would happen, mind everybody out there, let's say if you played football and let's say if you're a recruit and let's say if you went to a school in California, most likely you could probably get paid to play. So that gives some implications. That's good implications for those students maybe you want to play in the state of California because that rule might go into effect there.
Yeah.
So that's why it implicates college recruiting. Okay? So like, you know, so this is a game changer. This could be something major that's going to follow suit. And again, this is only in the state of California in which they're trying to make this law first for college athletes to get paid. And there are some powerful people out there who are for this bill. Like, for example, LeBron James. LeBron James is really for this bill. And LeBron James went on the tweet. He said, "Everybody in California, call your politicians and tell them to support the Fair Play to Pay Act." Okay, this law is a game changer. College athletes can responsibly, and I like the word when he used responsibly, I'll get back to that. But college athletes can responsibly get paid for what they do and the billions they create. Okay? And I like the word he used was responsible because they'll be getting paid responsibly, like not under the table. You know what I mean? That's irresponsible. So that's why I like the word he used was responsible, getting paid responsibly. Okay? You also have presidential candidate Bernie Sanders. He tweeted out and said, I'm going to try to use my Bernie Sanders imitation, okay? He says, college athletes are workers. Pay them. Okay? I don't know how good my accent was for Bernie Sanders, but that's Bernie Sanders.
Oh, that was good.
You like that accent,
yeah,
Mom?
Yeah,
okay, I appreciate that. Okay, cool. All right. So he says that college athletes are workers. College athletes are workers. Pay them. All right? Bernie Sanders. So Bernie Sanders says that. So you have some people who are for it. Whereas on the flip side, everybody out there, you got some people who are totally against this bill passing. Okay? And one of those opponents of it is Washington State's head football coach. His name is Mike Leach. Now, he opposes the bill, and he says the following. He says this, Mom. He says, "The state of California has trouble keeping their streets clean right now. So my thoughts is that they should probably ought to focus on that." Mm-hmm. Now, this is Mike Leach, the head football coach of Washington State, saying that. Now, Mike, first of all, Mike, what the hell are you talking about, man? First of all, what is this guy talking about? Saying, like, California has to have enough trouble cleaning their streets now. What does he mean? Like, crime or something like that? I mean, maybe they should focus on that and not, you know, having college athletes getting paid. I don't know. Mike Leach has been out there. He's been saying some wild things before. But this is wild.
That's crazy. You know, everyone else gets paid.
I know, right? Yeah, maybe now, you know, the athletes are kind of being in their pockets. You know, maybe that's why he opposes it.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know. But he's come out and said that. He says, yeah, the state of California has trouble keeping their streets clean right now. So my thoughts is that they probably ought to focus on that and not the student athletes. Mm-hmm. I don't know about that. You know, that's kind of nuts there. That's definitely kind of nuts. But, you know, my thoughts is, do you believe that the NCAA is ready for this transition to take place? You know?
Yeah.
I don't know. What do you think, Ma? You think
they're... audience.
No, well, okay. Well, can I ask? Okay, I take your lead, Ma. I think I ask the audience, do you think the NCAA is ready for the transition to take place because athletes getting paid? I have my two cents on it, but I'll get back to you, Ma. But for me personally, I think I'm not sure if the NCAA is ready for this just yet, but this is something that's going to come down. And I think, using California as kind of like the reference or like the guinea pig in this experiment is important and it's good because, you know, again, we're going to see, you know, these athletes should get paid in the revenues. You know, they should be, involved in the revenue streams of what's going on. And if you got to start in California, now, you know, it might be tough for like the, you know, and again, here's the deal. I think those athletes who gonna be your best players, and they're gonna get endorsement deals. Okay, let's like a football player, you know what I mean, like the best players, they're gonna get endorsement deals. Yeah. You know, and like other players might not. You know what I mean? In other sports, like let's say crew, you know, or I don't know, softball or something like that. But you know, I understand that, but you gotta pay those students who bring in the most revenue. Into the school conversation. So, you know, that's something that needs to be looked at. You know, that's something that needs to be looked at. And, you know, I know it might be unfortunate, but I think the kids can cash in on this. You know, I look at it like this, Ma. Just let's fast forward a little bit. You know, I play college basketball, right? And so let's say if the times were now, right? And let's say I went to a school in California. And this rule was in effect, right? And be a situation in which, you know, I'm a very good player. I go to UCLA, and I'm the best player. And I get an endorsement for Wheaties, right? I'm on the box of the Wheaties. Your boy, your baby boy is on the box of Wheaties, right?
Yes.
You know what I mean? So that can help, you know, help
yes.
out things, right?
Yeah, because a lot.
Yeah, because that can help, you know, pay for things, right?
That's
you know?
Right. You have to go well dressed.
Yeah,
for the clothing.
Absolutely, that'll pay for clothes.
And the snacks, you know how
and the snacks
like
and everything.
Snacks.
Yeah. And it goes back to in my, you know, it goes back to promise. See, I had a promise with my mom and dad in high school. I always told my mom, I said, Ma, I don't know if you remember this, but I always said to you, Ma, I said, hey, look, if you're able to pay for me for high school, you know, pay for my college, you know, high school education, you know, in the Catholic school. I'm going to get a scholarship, so I'm going to repay you. I don't know if you remember that conversation.
Yeah, I remember that very well.
Right, you know, so.
Yeah, and it happened.
Yeah, and so wouldn't it be great if I'm on the cover of a Wheaties box, I get an endorsement deal, so now I can take care of me, and then I can throw back some money back home to my folks in New York, you know what I mean? Because I got this endorsement deal. You know, I think it's a great idea.
Great.
Yeah.
That's
I think
it should be.
Yeah, I think so too. I think so too.
Bring millions of dollars.
Millions.
In.
Yep.
Millions.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, and again.
That's not fair.
Yeah. Yep. Now, you know, more athletes might get paid more than others, but that, hey, it's all about how much revenue they bring into the school.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I guess who's marketable? You got to be marketable people, you know, people who can be on the Wheaties box or Campbell's soup or something like that, you know, and get endorsement deals. So, you know, it might be one of those deals. But yeah, I think that can take place. I think that can definitely take place. You know, we're going to see. We're going to see how that goes. I am sweating. I don't know what it is, but it feels good. Yeah, but I don't know. It's going to be interesting to see that, Ma, you know.
Yeah.
And every little bit helps out. And I think going forward, if this does pass in California, you're going to see it open up in other markets as well, which they're going to have to open it up to the rest of the country.
Right.
You know, because what's going to happen is if you just do this in California and successful, the recruiting is going to be big in California because kids are going to want to go to those schools that are paying these athletes.
That's true.
Right. So, you know, so that's going to open it up for everything. Yeah. So if it's successful, it'll just branch out to the whole country.
It'll be a new day.
That's right. It'll be a new day, new pay, you know, for the athlete.
Right. That's right.
And I want my reparations because I was a college athlete. Once a college athlete, always a college athlete. It's a fraternity that is always involved there. So I want my reparations when this all comes about. Okay. John says, let's see what John says. As Chris Williams is joining us too. What's going on, Smooth? John says, I'm going to read what John says. John says, I do believe the kids should get some piece of that revenue. Set a standard amount for each. Sure, they get a free education, but it's still a struggle for them financially. Yes. No doubt about it. I realized that when I was in college, you know, if we'd had a little stipend, like John is mentioning, you know, a little stipend, a little something per month. That'll avoid, like, you know, you hear the horror stories of, like, you know, kids selling their sneakers or selling their championship rings, you know what I mean, just to get food and stuff like that. Because, you know, once the cafeteria is closed, you know, people are hungry 12 o'clock at night, you know, especially young kids. So a little stipend would go a long way. I'm with you on that, John, you know, and they need to get a piece of that revenue because they're bringing a lot of money to these college and universities.
That's right.
You know? Yeah, because people pay to see these athletes perform. They don't pay to see professors teach. All right? The players bringing the revenues to these schools, that's, you know, true. And they deserve to get a little piece of the pie.
They do.
Yeah, they deserve to get their beak wet. Right, Smooth? That's the inside joke, guys. But, you know, I would like to see that happen. We're going to see how that takes place. You know, we're going to see if California passes that law. And, you know, we're going to really see what the deal is on that. It's going to be really good.
Yeah,
that's going to be really good. Let's see. Somebody else says, Chris says, I want my money. So Chris is part of the reparations, the reparations reform as well. Yeah, that would be a great thing. That would be a great thing. And you know what would be? Yeah, you kind of be opening Pandora's box, but that's okay. Because what I'm saying is this, you know, this goes through. It goes to the rest of the country. And then those former athletes, because again, once a student athlete, always a student athlete, you get your reparation check in the mail. You know what I mean? So, you know, it's only right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hey, so, guys, while we ponder that, I want to go over a feel-good story that I was reading, I came across in terms of athletics. And that's about the University of Virginia, the head men's basketball coach, Tony Bennett. They recently won the NCAA championship, the men's, and Tony Bennett did a really good thing, really did an unprecedented thing, Mom, that I'm about to share with everybody there out here today. Tony Bennett recently declined a substantial raise by the university for winning a national title this past year. Now, check this out, guys. So instead of the coach asked that the financial investments be made to improve the basketball program and other sports under the University of Virginia's athletic program. So he declined the raise for himself, but he wanted that money to go to financial investment be made to improve the basketball program and the other sports at the school. Mm-hmm. Now, this is unprecedented out there.
Yeah.
We got Keisha joining us. What's going on, cuz? So, Coach Bennett, he specifically asked his athletic director to give additional money to his coaching staff to fund other improvements of the basketball program and to give the money to other programs of the university. Now, Coach Bennett, he's no fool, okay? Because he got this great idea from his wife.
Yeah.
Right? His wife gave him this great idea to do this. And, they said that, you know, and the coach said he felt that he has more than he needs. He has enough money already. Oh. You know, that's what he felt like.
Yeah.
He has more money than he needs. And he wanted to see others at Virginia benefit from what would have been his financial reward. So he wanted other people to benefit. You know, his family, they think they have enough, you know. So
that's great.
That is phenomenal, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. But wait. There's more to the story, ladies and gentlemen, because Coach Bennett, he's doing this. Him and his wife have pledged $500,000 to support a career development program for current and former Virginia players. Now, what that means is he's putting money into the college to the career development, because I'm a prime example of this, guys. When you make the transition from college student athlete to a career, mm-hmm. be a very difficult one.
Yeah.
It could be a very, very difficult one. I'm living proof of that as a former college student athlete. The transition would be very difficult. And so he is giving money into programs for career development to help his current players and his former players has successful and smooth transitions. I think that is phenomenal. Yeah, I think that is the great assist that he's given to his program. You know, I think that's a great thing that's going on there. I think that is so great. So, you know, not only he's investing his time, but he's investing his money on his past presence and past players and form, you know, and current players, insisting in their careers, because you're not going to play there for college forever, but dealing with their transition to help them to get to their to be part of their careers, he's devoting money into the player development and the career development, I should say, the career development.
Right.
I think that is phenomenal, and that's something that's unprecedented. I've never heard anything like that out there, ladies and gentlemen, in which a coach is turning down money and taking that money that he was going to get in terms of a raise and give it back to his staff and give it back to his school and other sports.
That's right.
Yeah, you're not going to find that.
Yeah, that doesn't happen.
Yeah, that doesn't happen.
Yeah.
That doesn't happen much at all. But I just wanted to share that story because that story is kind of like a heartwarming story, man. You know, you hear the different, you know, the different horror stories on like coaches and everything like that. But, you know, here's this coach is giving back and helping those student athletes transition to careers.
Right.
And that's a big one. That is so big. Yeah, you know. But what do you guys think out there, guys? What do you think? Do you think that's a noble gesture by the coach? Or do you think that was crazy? I want to find out what you guys think in that process. What you guys think about that. So we shall see. We shall see. Nah, so, but do you like the idea, Mom? I'm just going to grab some water.
I like it.
You like the idea? Okay. Do you have, I don't know. Well, the one thing... I would say
I like it. It should have been done years ago.
It should have been done years ago, right?
Yeah. Done years ago.
I think it's clear to say I bet you're not gonna see I really doubt it. I mean it would be great, but I wanna see how many other coaches do that, follow that lead. I'll be very curious to see if we see another coach doing that.
Oh, we won't.
You don't think so, Mom?
No.
Why not? Why don't you think that? Any reason why? Or you just think that was just like a one-time deal for this coach?
That's a one-time
deal. One-time deal. I don't know. You just never know. I mean, that's story.
That's true. You never know.
Yeah, that story you shocked me. That story shocked me. So
it always takes one to start.
That's true. It only takes one, the domino effect, you know. And
that's right.
Yeah, he's being a blessing, you know. Because the funny thing about Coach Bennett, I got two stories on Coach Bennett, okay? Well, the first story is this. I mean, if you watched our show a couple weeks ago, I had Kari Wilson on and I had Chris Williams on. And we talked about, we played against Tony Bennett in college.
Oh.
He went to Wisconsin, Green Bay. Kari Wilson and Kari Edwards, they converged on him. The last seconds, we stole the basketball. Kari Edwards went down and dunked the basketball. We won the game. Okay. Fast forward to now, Tony Bennett, 2 years ago, his team was the first team, the number one ranked team, to ever lose to a 16 seed. So, you know, he weathered the storm there and he reaped the benefits for this year winning the championship. And he always went back to that, you know, story saying how, like, we were on the top of the totem pole and now we're, you know, now we're number one, now we're champs. So, you know, that's a way of him giving back, I guess, back to the program, you know, the program who believed in him, you know, because maybe they could have got rid of the guy because of that, but they didn't, you know, and then they win the championship. So, you know, it's all about giving back and helping out others. And
that's true.
And that's what he seems to be doing for his program. Yeah, he seems to be doing that for his program. So, I just wanted to just leave it on that, you know, on a good gesture. You know, it's good to hear feel good stories like that, you know?
Yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. Yep. Hey, Ma, do you realize what time it is? You know what time it is?
What time is it?
It is time for our favorite segment, Miss May. Who are you rolling with? So, Mom, now. Oh, let me get the theme music. Hold on a second. I got to get the theme music.
Did you have some answers?
Let's see. Oh, I got your music going on. Now, alrighty. If you're just joining us, this is Miss May, Who You're Rolling With segment, my favorite segment of the show, in which my mom's going to choose from the lovely love mug. My mom's going to choose three different topics, and we're going to see which one Miss May is rolling with. So, Mom, please choose one at a time, please. I am sweating up a storm, man. I don't know what's going on here. I don't know. Must be these good questions I'm about to ask you. Okay, Mom.
Oh, yeah.
Now, Miss May, oh, this is a good one. Who are you rolling with here? The current president, number 45, or George W. Bush? Which president are you rolling with, Mom?
I'm rolling with Bush.
Bush?
Yeah.
Bush, you're rolling with Bush?
Bush,
okay,
yeah.
So you're rolling with him?
Yeah, I'm rolling with Bush.
Oh, okay. And it's funny,
anybody better than 45.
Anybody's better than 45?
Yeah.
I bet you George W. Bush is like, man, thank God for number 45, man, because I guess we forget all the stuff that went down with him, right?
Yeah,
because
right.
of what's going on with him, you know? And we got Dave joining. What's going on, Dave? So, you know, speaking of number 45, Ma, I had to ask you a question. Like, what is going on with number 45 and his jealousy with President Obama? You've been watching this in the media?
I don't know. What's wrong with him with Obama?
I don't know. He's been criticizing. He's
everything
been, yeah.
he could think of, he criticized.
Yeah, he criticized the former president for golfing too many times, whereas this president has golfed more than President Obama.
But President Obama has class.
Yes, he does have class. Yes. Yes, this number 45 has criticized President Obama for his new book deal and his Netflix deal.
Yeah.
I don't know why he's thinking about that at the time. We got other things to think about?
What I think about is jealousy.
Oh, you think it's jealousy, huh,
yeah,
Mom?
Jealousy.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. Dave says number 45 loves you, May, Miss May. I don't know. We'll that's another show entirely, right? That's another show.
that's another story.
Yeah, it's really mind-boggling about that. I mean, the jealousy, like you said, but...
Yeah, jealousy.
I quote a great hip-hop philosopher, Mace. And Mace had a line that says, "Don't hate me because you ain't me."
Yeah.
So, I don't know. Maybe he hates him because he's not him. I don't know. Well, who knows? I don't know. I don't know what's in that man's mind. Yep.
President Obama was smart.
Yes, he was smart.
He was smart.
And he had that swag, right, Ma? He had that confidence, that swag, right? I don't know. Is this something you can't explain, that coolness that he had?
Very popular.
Yeah, yeah. That'll cause some envy for some people. Yeah, right. You know? Yeah. Choose another one for you, Ma, please. Thank you. All right. All righty. Okay, Miss May. What are you rolling with here? Either early mornings or late nights. Which one do you prefer, Ma? Early mornings or late nights?
Oh, I'd rather have early mornings.
Hmm?
Early mornings.
Early mornings.
That's when I have my energy.
Okay. Do you have your energy early mornings?
Early mornings. Oh,
okay.
Have my energy.
Oh, okay. Cool. What time you normally wake up in the morning? You wake up early, Ma? Like, what time is early for you? I'm always wondering. What time is early? It's like 6 early for you, 7 or?
Yes, 6.
6 o'clock is good for you.
Yeah, 6 o'clock is good for me.
Okay, cool. All right. Mm-hmm. Hey, Dave says 45 has had the highest rated show on TV. Now Obama's getting his. Well, we'll see. Yeah, I don't know. We'll see on that, Dave. I mean, I'm assuming you're meaning The Apprentice that he had. And I don't know. You know what would be funny? You know what would be funny, Ma? Is because I know the president, number 45, is into ratings, right?
Yeah.
And I know
he loves ratings.
And I know one thing that he didn't get that the president might get an Emmy. Because, for example, what I mean by this is the following. President number 45, he never got an Emmy for The Apprentice, the show. That's something he always wanted. He always thought the show was the best, but never got an Emmy. But now you're going to have President Obama, who's going to be doing shows for Netflix. Uh-huh. He might be in the position to get an Emmy, and that might set number 45 over the top.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I don't know. We shall see.
Oh, he might have his heart attack.
Last one, Ma. Please choose that. All righty. Cool. All right. So, Ma, Miss May... this is a simple one. So I'll give you some simple questions today. Which one are you rolling with? Either washing dishes or drying dishes. Which one you like doing, Ma? If you had to choose. Washing dishes or drying dishes?
Washing dishes.
Washing dishes?
Washing dishes.
Really?
I'd rather wash them than the dryer.
You'd rather wash than dry?
Yeah, but I'd rather for the dishwasher to wash and dry.
Oh, okay.
That's what I'd rather do.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah. I'm with you on that. Like for me, I'm from the school in which if a person cooks for me, I have no problem drying the dishes. I mean, I have no problem washing the dishes. Matter of fact, if a person cooks for me, I'm going to wash the dishes and I'm going to dry the dishes too.
Oh, you're right.
You know?
You're washing, dry.
Yeah, that's
yeah, because
just me.
If you wash, you might as well dry.
That's true too, right? You might as well do it, right? Yeah, some people out there, I mean, they hate drying dishes, you know? And some people like washing dishes, but you like to wash the dishes.
I'd rather wash them.
Okay, you like to wash the dishes. Yeah. Okay, cool. Okay. Hey, Mom, we got Jeanette out there joining us from the D. What's up, cuz? Joining us from the D. Now, Mom, I got a bonus.
What does she like?
What does Jeanette like?
Yeah.
Or what does anybody else like? I don't know. Yeah, what do you guys like? Let us know out there. What are y'all like? Y'all like drying dishes or washing dishes? That's a good question, right, Mom?
Yeah. You're all included.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, yeah. And join us.
Give me an answer.
There you go. Yep. I got a bonus question for you, Mom. Now, I know your favorite show, probably one of your favorite shows of all time, came on yesterday, right? Dancing with the Stars, right?
Yeah, right.
Okay, you like Dancing with the Stars, right?
I like Dancing with
the Stars. Okay. Now, so...
Did you see that?
Ma, I haven't... How long has that show been on the air? Like 20 years or something like... It's been on for a long time, right?
Yeah, for a long time. How many years? I forgot.
At least 10 plus. Yeah. Right?
Oh, more than
More than that? Yeah. So probably close to 20 years. Mm-hmm. Okay, so out of those 20 years for Dancing with the Stars... You know how many times I've seen the show Dancing with the Stars?
How many times?
Zero times. Zero times.
Oh, it was really good last
yeah,
night.
Yeah, you liked it. Okay.
Now,
who are you rolling with so far now? Like, who do you think can, who do you think might can win it all, Dancing with the Stars? Like, if you had to choose, like, who would you like? Who would you roll with at the time?
Well, nobody last night. You know, it was first night.
Okay.
So I really cannot judge.
Okay.
But I can tell who will be off next week.
Uh-huh. Who?
Lamar
Odom? Really?
He will be off next week.
Oh, okay. You think Lamar Odom will be off? So you're not rolling with Lamar?
I'm not rolling with Lamar. I don't know why he was off, but I guess he got a... Man, living, you got to feed the family.
You got to feed the family, yeah.
You got to feed the family.
That's true. I think he has a great book out now. And Lamar Odom almost died, too. You know, he's in a coma,
right.
too. So, shout out to him for lasting this long, you know, doing his things.
That was courageous of him, you know.
So, you think he'll be kickoff?
Oh, of course.
Okay. Did you see...
Sean, you know, the secretary...
I was going to ask you, Sean Spicer. What did he do? You liked him?
No.
You know he was no good?
He didn't do nothing. he'd probably be the second one off.
Oh, he'll be the second one off?
He'll be the second one
okay.
off.
Okay. So those two you're not rolling with. Okay. Do you have a favorite thus far? Before you answer that, John talks about the washing and the drying. He says both of them. He says, my wife and I both cook together and do the dishes as we go. There you go, John.
Good.
There you go.
That I like that, John.
That's right.
That's what I do.
That's right.
I do them as I go.
That's right. And Dave says zero for him, too, meaning like he hasn't seen the show like myself.
Oh,
he hasn't seen the show.
You missed a good show last night.
Okay. We have Sherry watching us. What's going on, Sherry? Welcome to Transition Tuesdays. So you say, Ma, there's no clear-cut favorite for you, though?
No, not yet.
Not yet?
Not yet.
Okay. Uh-huh. What's his name? Is Ray Lewis doing it this year?
Yeah, Ray Lewis.
How did he do?
He was good.
He was good? He got some rhythm?
He was very good. Uh-huh.
Okay.
He might be
in the running?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, I'm sure he'll be in the running.
Okay. All right. Yeah, you got to tell me about it, because I'm not going to watch it.
Yeah.
So, you got to tell me about that, Ma, because...
Oh, I don't miss it.
You don't miss it?
No.
You've seen it for all these years?
Yeah, all these years.
Okay, cool. Do you have an all-time favorite person on the show that you liked or that you can remember? Because, again, I haven't seen the show. But do you have anybody like a favorite or
no?
No. Okay. Okay. I won't put no pressure on you. That's okay. You just enjoy it.
Watch them all.
You go watch them all. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. And you've been watching it?
Yeah, I've been
gotcha.
Watching.
Okay, cool. Well, my good friends, if we were able to make you laugh, smile, and think during our broadcast, you have accomplished something major today. So celebrate your victory, as we always say around here, right, Ma? Celebrate your victory.
Celebrate
the victory. You know, because that's so important. That's so, so important. You know, celebrate the victory of life. You know, small victories, like I always say, celebrate the small victories.
Small victories.
Because those small victories add up to major ones as well. So, you know, celebrate those small victories. Yep. So, like for you, Ma, celebrate the victory of watching Dancing with the Stars every week.
Yeah.
You got to celebrate that victory on your own, because I won't be watching that show. But that's okay. That's okay. You love it.
Yeah. Oh, I love it.
Good. Cool.
Entertaining.
Right. It's entertaining.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Cool. Well, Ma, I want to thank you once again for hosting the show, co-hosting the show. I really appreciate it. Love having you on. I love talking about Dance with the Stars with you. I know how much you like that show and other things. And,
yeah, I love it.
You know, and giving your insight on things. I really appreciate that. So, nah, Ma, I love you, Ma, and I'm glad you made the show once again. I mean, we make it a good streak, Ma. I mean, I'm telling you, you've been on the show. You know, you've been... You know, people come to see you. They don't come to see me. They come to see you. So when you on here, they come see you. I'm just saying. Okay. So, you know.
Good for them.
But I thank you, Ma. I thank you for coming on the show. I really do. I really do. And, yeah, so.
Happy to be here.
You're happy to be there?
Yeah.
Cool. Thank you, Ma. I appreciate you. So I want to thank everybody out there for watching Transition Tuesdays this week. And before we go, I want to make a quick announcement. I want to announce my oldest daughter, Taya. She's going to be turning 18 years old on Saturday, September 21st. So, Taya, if you're watching out there, happy birthday. I know your birthday's not yet, but this, I'm just shouting you out here on you know, live. Just happy birthday to you, 18 years. Oh, man, such a blessing being your dad. Really loving you. Turning 18, you're going to get a chance to vote. Maybe get some people out of office with your vote. You know what I mean? One vote, every vote counts. So now you get a chance to vote. You know, I'm so proud of you. So proud of you, the young lady that you're becoming. And, you know, happy birthday to you. So on the 21st. But I'm just shouting you out now. Just shouting you out now. So, ladies and gentlemen, as we say in parting, happy transitioning. And we'll talk to you soon. Take care, everybody.
Bye-bye.